So, part five. So we're now in the Fed. We're in this point here. It's December 23rd in 1913. And they're trying to get the bill passed at midnight on the day before Christmas Eve. It's a gentleman's agreement that they don't pass any bills of any significance as the Christmas holidays approach. Gentleman's agreement. Well, they pass it, you know, in the dark of night, and Woodrow Wilson gets elected in the 14th, let's see, this was December 23rd in 1914. Woodrow Wilson gets elected, and all the presidents after Teddy Roosevelt are all just pigeons. They're just, you know, puppets, all of them. And they're all, let's see here. I have made out a chart for you guys to do a cut and paste and make your own chart, and you may want to leave yourself more room to make notes in there. But Woodrow Wilson beat Howard Taft. And Howard Taft was extremely popular Republican. And he lost to Woodrow Wilson. And so Woodrow Wilson was, he did his part to make sure to, he was a crypto Jew. His real name was Wolfson, Wolefson. And he had a name change and a very nice background that's not a word of truth in it. Let's see, then Harding, Coolidge, Herbert Hoover. Roosevelt was not our crowning glory. Let me explain something to you. I grew up in a household where my grandfather hung pictures of FDR and Truman and JFK over his bed. His own volition that he did this. So that was the kind of environment that I grew up in. And, you know, a working man and terribly appreciated his leaders and thought they could do no wrong and so forth. Anyway, Woodrow Wilson. And we're off to the races with World War I. You read, try to find information on what started World War I, and you get offered peculiar things, really peculiar reasons. You know, some archduke got assassinated. You don't go to war over assassinations. I mean, consider us with JFK, you know. Going to war was not a consideration for one person. Or even 250 person, like the Marine barracks there in Lebanon. Because one war can lead to thousands, to lead to millions. So that's the name of that. So it's very hard. I've noticed it's very hard to get a war going, and it's hard to keep it going. So the Rothschilds really have their work cut out for them to keep the wars going so that the munitions and the weaponry industry can cash in. We'll get to Franklin D. Roosevelt later. Let's see, how many points have I got here? Okay, you'll see here we've got